In this video, we're going to take a look at what is RPA and talk about some of the benefits that organizations are realizing as they start to implement RPA within their workplace. So the first thing we want to look at is what is RPA? Now, the definition of RPA, just as an acronym, stands for Robotic Process Automation. Now, that in itself probably doesn't help us to really define what it is. So I'm going to give a definition here. The definition I would give is specialized software robots that automate high volume, repetitive, rule-based tasks in an auditable and reliable way. And so what that means is it's essentially these software bots, and we'll have another definition here, these software bots that emulate human operations on top of applications to automate transactions, okay? And so when we think about that, we think about these high volume tasks where humans are asked to kind of play the bridge between two different applications that don't otherwise have a good way of being able to communicate with each other. And so we might be moving data from one application to another, or we might be initiating transactions where transactions couldn't be kicked off automatically. And so those high volume tasks that are very repetitive, very rule-based, are a great use case for RPA and specifically Automation Anywhere. The way I want to look at this is let's look at a really sample use case so we can all kind of understand what a real, you know, task would look like and then how a bot could come into play to actually automate that. So let's look at a customer onboarding process. It starts off with spreadsheets being dumped into a share drive. We know that a lot of organizations, hey, it looks really digital. It looks like a digital experience from the front end, but the back end isn't always tied well together with the front end. And so in this example, we'll say that spreadsheets representing new customer details are being dumped off to a share drive. Humans are then looking for those spreadsheets to enter that data for those new customers into a legacy terminal application. If you're not familiar with what terminal means, it's those black screens. Sometimes it's colored text, sometimes it's just white, where you're just entering data into a, you know, into a text box and you're just entering the text commands. You're not really using your mouse, you're not clicking and dragging on anything, stuff like that. We'll then enter the data into a workflow application and we'll use that workflow application to initiate the welcome packet. So if we look at that really basic sample process there, hopefully it's high volume, right? Hopefully we've got lots of new customers coming on board all the time. It's repetitive. It's the same thing every time. I take the spreadsheet, I enter the data into this terminal application, I enter some of the same data into this workflow application, I initiate the welcome packet, right? It's the same thing. It's rule-based. I know exactly what I need to do at each step. There might be exceptions at each step that I need to look out for, right? Hey, I'm missing a zip code. What do I do if I miss a zip code? Or hey, this person doesn't look like they have a valid US address. What do I do in that case, right? So we have those rules and the bot could accommodate those rules the same way that a human could, but it's a very repetitive process. And part of where a bot can add a lot of value here is that think about the way that you would do this. If I got a spreadsheet and someone said, hey, enter the data into these two apps and then start this welcome packet initiation, right? At first, I might just copy the data from the spreadsheet and paste it into those applications, and that would probably work fine. But eventually, I'm going to get to the point where I'm like, you know what? I think I remember that zip code, and it's probably faster for me to type it instead of it is for me to copy and paste it. And so now I've introduced the ability for me typing things and then sometimes I'm copying and sometimes I'm pasting and sometimes I'm typing. That's introduced the possibility for a lot of keystroke errors, right? I'm not perfect when I'm typing this stuff in. And so that introduces the possibility for error. And what we're looking at with bots is that we can automate those types of steps in an auditable and very reliable way. The bot's not gonna do, you know, sometimes copy things and sometimes keystroke things. It's gonna be done the exact same way every single time. Now, let's talk about some of the benefits of RPA and why an organization might use RPA. So first off, improve productivity. Bots enable us to get more done with the same staffing levels. We can augment what our staff is doing by automating certain tasks and then allowing the staff to still, you know, do that final approval or do that submission process. We have speed and accuracy. The bots can do things the same way every single time. And that means that we can execute transactions much more quickly. We can make sure that they're always done the exact same way. It's not sometimes I copy and paste and sometimes I hand key it. The bot's gonna do the same thing every single time. Faster turnaround times. We can make for an improved customer experience. Because we're able to automate a lot of these transactions, if a transaction comes in at 2 a.m. when we wouldn't otherwise have staff available to process that transaction, the bot could do it completely automated and then send a note back to the customer saying, hey, your transaction is finalized, it's waiting for final approval, or it's waiting for whatever step is next. Improved employee morale. Humans can focus on human tasks and not robotic tasks. Most people are surprised, but the University of London did a bunch of research and they found that humans that were working in augmented workplaces, which meant that they were working alongside automated or bot counterparts, had a much higher level of employee morale than organizations that were fully manual. And so we want to free humans from those really mundane, really robotic kind of tasks that they're doing so that they can focus on more cognitive tasks or tasks that require emotional intelligence. Full auditing capabilities. So I have increased compliance with all of our internal audit. And we can make sure that we're doing things the exact same way every single time. We can make sure we're logging that, and we have a full history of any action the bot has taken. A low barrier to entry. With Automation Anywhere, it's a cloud-native application, and the development interface is all on a web page. And so it's clicking and dragging. It's dragging these actions one by one, chaining them together. A very low barrier to entry. We find that business analysts are able to create their own bots, create their own automations. But the really nice thing about Automation Anywhere is it also enables advanced developers to do even more. And so you can do Python scripts, you can have JavaScript, you can even create your own packages in Java, and then enable other developers or those business analysts to use those packages to accelerate their own bot development. Scalability and flexibility. I have the ability to quickly scale up to accommodate unexpected volumes. So this could be at tax time or at end of quarter when we have to run all these financial reports. I have the ability to have a pool of bot runners. They can just take that work whenever it comes in, and I can send that work to essentially a digital army of workers, and they can take on that work and scale very quickly. And finally, compatibility with existing systems. And this is, I think, the number one benefit of RPA. It can work on top of older applications or applications that were homegrown or home built. That could be a legacy terminal app. That could be some web page that we made internally and the guy who wrote it isn't here anymore, or some Windows thick client app. Or it could be more modern applications that actually have an application programming interface, actually have a really rich way of connecting with their data. The bots can work kind of in between all of that, which is really nice because it allows us to move really fast where an API is available, and it allows us to still automate on top of those legacy applications. So that's what RPA is all about. Hopefully you found some of this helpful. I'm Micah Smith with Automation Anywhere. Go be great.